It's a battle of nationally ranked squads as number one seed St. John's faces second seeded Paul VI in the WCAC Girls Basketball Championship. Hi, basketball fans. Jeremy Huber here with Andy Mendoza. And Andy, you can feel the energy here in Bender Arena tonight.
Yeah, it's electric. Two great teams, two great coaches. Both teams littered with next-level talent. Should be a fantastic game.
Should be a fun one to watch. Remember, these two teams split the season series. Paul VI didn't lose again. St. John's only lost one to a team from California. So an interesting matchup tonight. Let's jump right into it. We start off with St. John's and their keys to the game. What do they have to do to go get the win tonight, Andy?
Defense wins championships, and they really want to make sure that they control that side of the floor. Play with tempo. They are a fast-paced team. They want to get up and down. They want to score a lot and make free throws. They want to get to the free throw line, and they need to capitalize.
Let's go ahead and look at our players to watch for St. John's in this one. We start off at a guard spot and Asia Shepherd,
the team's leading scorer, first team all-conference. She's really going to have to play above that average of 14 points per game and 78 made three-pointers on the season. She's going to have to be big tonight.
Our second player to watch in this one, another guard, it's Nia Beverly.
Yeah, she actually rolled her ankle last night. She's really the engine that gets the offense going for St. John's. A double-digit score, really good. Not a great free throw shooter, but she's a good field goal shooter. And she's going to, we'll see how long she can go with that ankle.
First team all-conference for Beverly this year as well. Our third player to watch, it is a small forward. It's Jalen Carradine.
She's going to have a big night tonight. She's really the third option usually for St. John's, but with Nia being injured, she's going to have a huge night.
Let's look at our keys to the game for Paul VI seeking another WCAC championship.
Yeah, they pride themselves on defense. It's a history story program, and they've always prided themselves on defense. They want to share the ball. They have a lot of balanced scoring, and they need to take care of the ball. They want to keep St. John's out of the fast break.
Let's look at our players to watch for the Panthers. We start off in the front court with Michaela Vaughn.
Yeah, double-digit scorer there. You see 15 points per game, 71% from the free throw line. She's number 90 ranked by ESPN, and she's committed to Notre Dame, pretty good school.
Yeah, headed off to Notre Dame in the fall. Our second player to watch, it's a guard spot, and it is Ashley Owusu.
Ashley Owusu, a really, really talented sophomore. ESPN has her ranked number 12 in her class. She already has offers from Maryland and Ohio State.
And our third player to watch tonight, it's another one in the front court. It's Mimi Collins.
Mimi Collins might be the best player on the floor we see tonight in this game. Number 27 in the ESPN rankings, and she's committed to Tennessee.
Well, we had a chance to catch up with both coaches before this one. Our Anna Tarullo first, catching up with the head coach of the St. John's Lady Cadets, Jonathan Scribner.
All right, Coach, your point guard, Nia Beverly, she hurt her foot headed into tonight's game. What can you tell me about her injury?
She did. I mean, she actually twisted her ankle. She's going to give it a go. She's taped up. She's had treatment over the last 24 hours, and so we'll see. Hopefully she can get out there and give it her best.
Definitely. Now, you like to play an up-tempo, fast offense. How do you generate that rhythm off the bat?
Well, I mean, other players are going to step up and create it. We have more than just one player who creates that tempo for us, so everybody's got to be bought in. It starts with a rebound. We got to get out and run. Got to get out and run, and we got to be in good defensive stances and creating great defensive pressure for the whole length of the floor, and we have to be committed to it.
Now, Paul VI has a lot of offensive weapons. What do you have to do to stop him tonight?
Listen, we just got to play solid, okay? Just play solid, put your hands up on shots, box out. Okay, they all can play, so can we. And, if we do what we're supposed to do, we'll be all right.
All right, great. Thank you so much, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you much, Anna. Also had a chance to catch up earlier with the head coach of the Paul VI Panthers, their longtime coach, Scott Allen.
All right, Coach, what's going to be the biggest battle you're going to have to win out on the court to come away with the win tonight?
We've got to defend. We've got to be able to stop their penetration, and they're an attacking type of team that really likes to get to the rim and be really aggressive of driving the ball to the basket. And they got a really good, they're very talented, and and Shepherd's just such a good player. So we've got to limit her touches and keep them out of the paint, keep them off the glass, and hopefully we can commit to taking care of the ball a little bit as well.
Now, St. John's does like to play fast. How are you going to slow them down?
Well, I mean, you've got to take really good shots so they don't get runouts, offensively off your missed shots. And I just think you just got to stay in front of them as much as you can and limit their ability to drive to the basket. I mean, they're really, really good at attacking the paint and getting in the lanes and creating help situations, and then they're also really good on the glass when they miss. So, you know, I don't know. We're just going to try our best we can.
All right, great. Thank you, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you much, guys. Of course, getting ready for this matchup. And we'll take a quick break for the sportsmanship creed of WCAC.
Groups. Please refrain from booing, taunting, or intimidating officials or opponents. Such behavior is unfriendly and unacceptable. Please respect the integrity and judgment of game officials. They are doing their best to promote the student athlete and the game we love so much. Be a positive representative of the school community. Please rise and remove your hats as we honor America with our national anthem.
And now our quick break for our national anthem.
Oh, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the
And with that, we're almost ready for basketball here at the WCAC Girls Basketball Championship. Top-seeded St. John's, number 2 seed, Paul the 6th. Should be a good one for us tonight. It's actually funny, Andy. I think in the pregame we talked a little bit to Coach Scott Allen, and he made a joke that his team actually on the other bench this time because they had won the last three of these. They used to be in the top seed.
Yeah, and he also mentioned how they were, their locker room wasn't the most accommodating of suites. But, you know, he's excited to be out here, and he mentioned that the only team that they feel that can beat them is themselves. So you expect PVI to come out fired up.
Let's go ahead and take a look at our starting lineups in this one. We'll go ahead and start with Paul the 6th, and, of course, their starting lineup in this contest. They'll go ahead at a guard spot with Honesty Scott Grayson. Also, they'll go ahead with Ashley Owusu at a guard spot. Like Kim Kowitz will also be at a guard. Mimi Collins and Michaela Vaughn will be starting in the front court as well. Some good height in this one for Paul the 6th, Andy, and that was something Scott Allen really wanted to see if he could hopefully utilize today.
Yeah, Coach mentioned wanting to work the ball inside into the paint and using that size as an advantage today.
Let's go ahead and take a look at that starting lineup now for St. John's. And some questions in this one. Scott Allen at one point was not exactly sure what he would go with. This is what we were given before the game. We'll see if it sticks with us. But guard spots, Sydney Wood, Asia Shepherd, also Naya Beverly. and forward spot, Asia McCray. Then at the center spot, Malu Shitenge Mutombo. Yes, that is the niece of Dikembe Mutombo. They had a game last week, the IAC Championship. Bullis had one of his nephews on that team. So, again, it is a family affair when it comes to Mutombo. It's always a big-time name when it comes to basketball in D.C.
Absolutely, and, of course, they always come with size, too. It's a big family, but we'll see how Nia Beverly can, how long she can hold up on that ankle. Of course, you see three guards there for St. John's in the starting lineup. They want to push the tempo. They want to push the pace, and having the guards out there, having the ball handlers will help them do that.
Let's go ahead and almost ready to get this one started. There's Jonathan Scribner, the coach of St. John's. And on the other side of things, it'll be for Ball the Six, Scott Allen. So how we get here, St. John's beating Holy Cross and Seton, while Paul the Sixth beat McNamara and Good Counsel. So really not too close, though. That Seton game yesterday did get close before eventually St. John's was able to pull away in the contest.
And of course that was affected by Nia Beverly getting hurt in that game. And we mentioned, we'll see how long she can go today. Coach mentioned that she has that ankle heavily taped.
It's almost ready to get going in this one. St. John's is in the gray, while Paul the Sixth in the black. So glad you can be with us for the WCAC Basketball Championship as Paul the Sixth wins the tap. They're gonna say,
I was wondering if they were going to see that.
So we are good to go as we'll flip it around. And St. John's will start off the first possession.
And a quick shot.
Corner three put up and no good.
We mentioned that's what St. John's wants to do. They want to push the pace. You're going to see a lot of early shots, and as you see them now opening up in a full court press.
So Paul the Sixth. Again, only one loss on the season. It came against St. John's. Wusu kicks back. Air ball there, but Vaughn for the putback. It'll be knocked out of bounds by Collins and goes over to St. John's.
And an early offensive rebound for Paul the Sixth. You mentioned the size being a big factor today.
Yeah, again, a lot of height, and now some pressure being applied by Paul the Sixth.
We'll see how St. John's handles that pressure. Of course, Nia Beverly's got the hurt ankle.
Into the corner. Scott Grayson hits it, and a two-pointer to start things off.
You see a little pace there from Paul the Sixth, pushing it, getting an early open shot, a good look, knocking it down.
Kick back out. Beverly, pull-up jumper, and good.
And that's what St. John's wants to do. They want to get the ball to the paint, and they want to be able to push the tempo, score, and set up their press.
So St. John's throwing everybody a curveball as Sydney Wood could be wearing number two today. So we'll try and keep you up to date best we can on these numbers. I think we're wearing an old set of jerseys. And maybe it was funny, we're talking ahead of time to Jonathan Scribner, had said, I had to check something with the referees. I wonder if that's what he had to check.
Yeah, we did think it was a little odd when we asked the pregame for the starting lineup, and he said he had to talk to the ref. I never heard that one before, but that makes sense now with the jersey numbers as Paul the Sixth pushes the pace a little bit.
So down the lane and scoring it will be Ashley Owusu.
It's a great little runner for her in the paint. She had an open look and high percentage shot there.
Kick back. Into the corner, St. John's. Again, just two losses on the season. Cross-court pass, and Klemkowitz going to come up with it. Numbers for Paul the Sixth. She'll take it in. Can't get it to go, and Mutombo's there for the rebound.
That last possession for St. John's is really kind of stagnant. Not a lot of movement on offense. We'll see if they can get some better looks as the night goes on.
Turn around in the paint, and a foul going to be called on Vaughn.
Interesting to see St. John's giving Paul the Sixth a little bit of their own medicine, working the ball inside and getting to the free throw line. McRae is going to take two shots here.
So McRae's first is up and good.
And we mentioned one of the keys to the game in pregame was make free throws. St. John's really wants to get to the line, but they need to capitalize once they get there.
So McRae will go for another. McRae's second is no good, and Collins tracks down the rebound.
It's always tough when you miss a second shot because you can't set up the press like we know St. John's wants to do.
Clem Kowitz, the Boston College commit, cross-court pass to Scott Grayson. Traffic there. Now Owusu down the lane. We'll kick it off, and an easy finish there for Michaela Vaughn.
Great job there by Owusu, a sophomore, not losing her composure when she gets in the paint, finding the open player.
Shot up and good.
It's a big shot. We talked about St. John's wanting to push the pace, and they get an early open three there, able to knock it down.
That one no good. Asia Shepherd with that last three. So I think we finally, folks, figured out exactly our number situation here as we'll have a travel.
Great defense there by Scott Grayson to cause the travel.
It was funny, Andy. We looked down at our roster, and about three of the numbers were completely different. It looks like they've really swapped up. Jalen Carradine, listed both in the program and the numbers we got, actually is number three, is number two. She's number three. Sydney Wood wearing number two tonight. Asia Shepherd in 22 and Asia McRae with 35. So we are hoping we can keep these for you, keep track of these folks as it's 6-6. Carly Rivera now into the game as she at the point almost take it away. Carradine dishes away. Rivera, three goes down.
Yeah, we mentioned St. John's wants to push the pace, and there they've gotten two open threes in the last two possessions and knocked them both down. I think Coach Scribner just wanted to keep us on our toes with the numbers.
I think he did. Collins up top. Carradine guarding closely. Backdoor cut. Klemkowitz kicks it back up top, and Owusu has to run it down. Shot from the free throw line, around and out. Mutombo rebounds.
Apollo 6 is playing a little bit out of control right now on offense. They need to kind of slow down, keep their composure, work the ball inside.
Wood back out to Rivera. Rivera off the front rim, no good.
And this is the pace St. John's wants to play at. This will play right into their hands.
Klemkowitz misses there. Rivera pushing. Shepherd pull up three. Around and out, no good. Mutombo with the rebound. Strong move against Collins. Can't get it to go. And Vaughn with the rebound. Scott Grayson back to Vaughn. Of course, Notre Dame signee. No shot. Paul the Sixth with a bevy of talent.
Yeah, both teams are really loaded, but Paul the Sixth has got a Tennessee commit, a UConn commit. I mean, they are really, really loaded, especially on the offensive end.
Kick out. Collins at the buzzer with a baseline jumper.
And there's the Tennessee commit. That's her first basket of the game. See if Paul the Sixth can get her going a little bit.
And Collins, an interesting story. Started her career at St. John's, finishes up at Paul the Sixth. They'll say that goes off of Mutombo and over to Paul the Sixth.
It seems like early on the pace of play really kind of plays into St. John's hands.
Yeah, most definitely. And it was one of the things that Coach Allen was a little bit concerned about. And you have to wonder, was it because of the bigs on his team?
Yeah, he mentioned he wants to, on offense, wants to work it on the inside, get it to the paint, get it to their bigs. And, you know, when you have Mimi Collins down there on the post, I could understand why.
Yeah, Vaughn as well. Klemkowitz can't finish. And Carradine up the court, trying to take it all the way, cut off by Owusu. Layup no good, and Vaughn will push it the other way. Paul the Sixth had numbers, and they'll be thrown away, so maybe that's a little bit of that pace, Andy, that Paul the Sixth didn't want causes a turnover.
Absolutely, as Coach Allen throws his hands up, wondering why his center didn't throw it to his guard, and that's exactly what St. John's wants. Cadets really doing a good job early in this game, pushing the pace on offense and getting Paul the Sixth out of rhythm on defense.
To Rivera in the game, played some good minutes yesterday. when Beverly went out with the ankle injury. That one put up and good.
That was a great pass. Great cut, great cross-court pass. Usually those are dangerous, but she was wide open on that one.
Asia Scott with the score, also wearing a different number than her program number. Pull-up jumper off the glass, no good. There's Mimi Collins, though, with a big rebound over Carradine and able to go ahead and get a chance to go to the line as Carradine picks up the foul.
And that's what makes the Panthers so tough. Even when you force them into a bad shot, they've got the bigs, they've got the athleticism to pull the offensive rebound down and make you pay.
Collins, an interesting study, as first one up and good. Mimi Collins, Amira, her real name, father of former basketball player in New Orleans, actually played soccer growing up and really kind of said that's one of the reasons her hands are very good because of all the soccer goalie that she played.
Bit ironic that playing soccer will make you good with your hands.
Well, that's the one spot on the field
that'll
I think
work.
It would work. So St. John's with the early one-point lead.
And a lot better movement and flow on offense for St. John's as they make another basket.
Finished there by Carradine, and the lead grows to three. Vaughn on the post, but she'll be fouled as McCray gives it up.
And you wonder if the size of Paul VI is going to force St. John's into a zone eventually to work on, to try to be able to give help to those bigs.
Yesterday, St. John's went a lot with their 1-3-1. Elizabeth Seton took some advantage of it as Vaughn misses off the front rim.
It was interesting when you talked to Coach Allen about that, about the 1-3-1 for St. John's. He mentioned how Seton, although they got a lot of layups, they also turned the ball over a lot and was worried a little bit about that defense. We haven't seen it yet, though, from St. John's.
And it's interesting, I think, Andy, if they go to that at some point, because of the height, as Vaughn knocks down the second, will those layups that maybe guards aren't hitting will be made by 6'5 and 6'3?
Absolutely. The size is an advantage, but if you're rushing, it doesn't matter how wide open you are, it's going to make it tough. And so far we've seen Paul VI just a little bit rushed, a little bit out of rhythm.
So Paul VI coming with some pressure, and a foul going to be called as a bump from Kayla Henderson. Look at some of the crowd here tonight. St. John's, of course, their boys were in last year, that team led by Anthony Cowan that knocked off DeMatha. Cowan kind of already had been a really top-notch player, but that is just a fantastic showing by him in that game. Other way, Scott Grayson's going to score it and take the harm as well. She'll have a chance at a three-point play.
That's a great job finishing with the left hand with the contact, and she's limping a little bit. We'll hope she's okay as she goes to the free throw line, try to convert the and one. But that was a great, great example of turning defense into offense there.
So Asia Shepherd going to pick that foul up. Scott Grayson able to hit and give Paul VI the 14-13 lead.
We keep mentioning the pace of St. John's. Expect them to sub a lot to keep those legs fresh.
Kick out. Down the lane, and what a finish there by Shepherd.
That's a tough basket. She throws her hands up looking for a foul. I thought she should have gotten one, too. Great take by her.
Scott Grayson will kick it out, long range three. That'll miss and just catch the backboard. Here's some numbers at the end of the quarter, and that one will not go down as we end the opening period with St. John's holding the 15-14 lead here at Bender Arena